Hey folks, Josh here, JM Custom Woodworks. Today we're talking about filing a ripping chain that's on my steel MS660 chainsaw. I got a 36 inch bar, full house rip chain on the Granberg Alaskan sawmill. Stay tuned. Hey guys, so we're in the vise here. You guys see this tooth right here? We've got a full house rip chain on the Alaskan mills in the vise, all attached. And I just want to show you how I've been sharpening these. I've got myself it's a still file, it's 7/32. You can see the numbers on the bottom, right in here, 7/32. And what I'm doing is essentially this corner piece has been rounded over by maybe a rock or whatnot. Always get yourself a good file. Keep a bunch handy nearby because they do wear out after you sharpen a few times. So have a stockpile of them. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by getting the gullet. Buck and Billy Ray taught me this. It's that little C shape in the cheek plate of the tooth that you want to get for throwing sawdust out. Mind you, these teeth are sitting at 10 degrees versus your standard teeth that are 25, 30 degrees. This is for ripping slabs. So I'm really focusing on pushing downward to create the C. The inside of this file, half the file, let's focus here, half the file is a C shape. And that's what we're putting in the tooth itself, is that C shape. So I can feel already it's getting sharper, and you can actually see how smooth that glides. This is where when I get that smoothness, I can barely just touch that and it's going through good, about 10 degrees. Now I start pulling back on the tooth. And with the tooth going down on an angle from a side view, like the teeth here are going down. Now the C shape is basically riding down that tooth, and we're working on getting that top bit of burr off. So that way we have a gullet, a working corner, and your angle creating a sharp tooth. So a couple more passes, little sweeps. That tooth is sharp, ready to rip. There you go, guys. That's the C shape right there. On this tooth, this is your tooth. And the C shape right there. See that? Where the tip of my finger is. Looks like a half moon. That's what's throwing sawdust out. You can see on the side of the cheek plate here. I was milling up cedar the other day, and you can see it riding on that. So having a C there with a working corner, which is that point, sawdust has somewhere to go. It's basically you're not spinning your wheels at this point. That's a good sharp chain right there. All right, guys, thanks a bunch. Appreciate you watching the video. Hopefully you liked it. We got to talk a little bit about ripping chains and how to sharpen them and the degrees it takes and what they do and all that good stuff. So anyhow, hit like, subscribe if you're interested in more. Have a good night, guys.